Happy guys, how are you? Welcome back to my channel. So by the time that you see today's video, I will have landed in sunny San Diego. I'm so excited about this trip, you guys. The reason why I'm heading out to San Diego is because I will be attending a female entrepreneurship event called Pays to Be Brave. And I will head out to California just a couple days prior to the event as well in order to kind of make this a little mini vacation. So I will be posting as much as I can on my Instagram stories. If you want to follow along, this is what my handle is. And if you're newer to my channel, on my Instagram account, I post all about health and fitness. I also talk a lot about how paying attention to ingredients in the food that I was eating changed my life. But not only do I pay attention to the ingredients in my food, I also pay attention to the ingredients in my personal care items. So for today's video, I thought that it would be a really good idea for me to share with you the items that I like to take whenever it is that I travel, specifically my more natural personal care and some healthy snacks. So if this does sound like a video that you're interested in, then let's go ahead and get started. All right, so I have all my items laid out beside me, and when I travel, I like to take a suitcase and a backpack. The reason why I take a suitcase is because that just means there's more room for potential souvenirs along with different outfits. I am that person who will go on a vacation for 5 days and will literally feel the need to pack like 30 outfits. I have no idea why I'm like this. I'm sure there's a lot of ladies out there who can relate on what it is that I'm talking about. So I'll start off with my more natural personal care items and then talk about the healthy snacks that I pack. Starting off with my shampoo and conditioner. The one that I like to take is the Acure brand. This is the argan oil and pumpkin scent. I have tried some of their other scents before, but this is just my absolute favorite. And I won't be taking the full size bottle. That's just a little too much for what I will be there for. So instead, what I like to do is buy these small plastic bottles, put my shampoo and conditioner in here, and these bottles you can pretty much find anywhere. I think I got them either from Walmart or Target. Next is going to be the body wash. This is from the brand Olivia. It's their enzymatic body cleanse with Arcadian sea kelp and coconut oil. It sounds so fancy, but the reason why I love it so much is because it's only made up of 7 ingredients. I've also put that in a small plastic bottle. The other thing will be body lotion and face lotion. This is from the same brand of the shampoo and conditioner that I just showed you, but this is Acure's Seriously Soothing 24-Hour Moisture Lotion, and this is in the unscented scent. I've also put that in a small plastic bottle. For skincare, I used to be a person who didn't really have a skincare routine, and then I thought, okay, there might be some benefit into having a skincare routine. So I don't know too much about skincare, but I have a brightening facial scrub that I like to use and a Seriously Soothing cleansing cream. These are also from the brand Acure, and I will be taking the full size bottle of this just to make my life a little bit easier instead of trying to squeeze all of that into a plastic bottle. The next item I don't have up here with me. I'll put a picture of what it is here on the sides, but it's feminine products. I love these feminine products because they're on the more natural side, and I do like getting them at Target, but I won't be taking any of them on the duration of this trip because I'm not gonna be on my period. I track my period and I have a really good idea as to when I'm going to have my period. The deodorant and chapstick. You guys have heard me talk about this brand in my favorites videos and then in my armpit detox video. Yes, I did an armpit detox where I talked all about this deodorant, but the reason why I had to do an armpit detox is because I wanted to switch from a conventional deodorant to a more natural. And so doing an armpit detox does help out with that transition period. But the brand is called Primally Pure. This is their charcoal scent. And this one by far is my absolute favorite. I've tried the lavender and the blue tansy scent as well, but I will link that armpit detox video down below in the description if you are interested in that. I also take a deeper dive and talk about the ingredients that are in your conventional deodorant that are pretty toxic. If you're wondering what the inside looks like, this is what it looks like. For my chapstick, because sometimes planes do tend to get a little dry and I feel like I need to put some chapstick on while I'm flying. It's the same brand as the deodorant, Primally Pure. This is their one in cocoa and I love it because it's only made up of 3 ingredients. Not quite sure how well you'll be able to see them. The next 2 items will be my toothbrush. There's nothing special about my toothbrush, it's just a regular toothbrush. But the toothpaste that I use is the Dr. Bronner's brand. This is their all-in-one toothpaste in peppermint. And I really like it because it's made up of better ingredients. And then it is also fluoride-free. And this pouch right here, I just have my contacts and some eye drops. And when you're on vacation, you never know what can happen if you get hurt or something like that. So I always take this little box here with band-aids and stuff like that. I also have some organic hand sanitizer. This is from the same brand of the toothpaste that I just showed you. They do have another scent in this in peppermint, I want to say, but I just got the lavender. Since we're going to sunny San Diego, you gotta have your sunglasses. And then I also got some Badger sunscreen. This is the zinc oxide sunscreen cream in the SPF 35. And the other thing that I have over on this side is my vitamins. So I like to pack them in this thing called a go stack. So this is what it originally looks like. I will only need, you know, the small portion of this for my vitamins, but it's called go stack, like I said, and I think I got it from Amazon. Okay, so I've shown you everything on this side, moving over to this side, starting off with these baby wipes. These are from the brand Water Wipes, and I like using these to clean my hands off, clean my makeup off. I get them from Walmart or Target. Got a hair brush, a straightener. This is the Wet to Straight straightener. I have no idea where it is that I got it. I've had it for such a long time. It was probably Target. In this little pouch, some scissors, nail clippers, and a tweezer. This, I have no idea where it is that I got it either because I've had it for such a long time. I got some more hair ties that I'm forever losing, some bobby pins, and then I will be putting in some hair clips. For makeup, first and foremost, I am not a beauty guru or anything like that. I just have found something that I really like. It's more natural and it just looks more natural on my skin. So I used to use liquid foundation and I didn't really like the way that that looked on my skin. It always looked caked on. Maybe I just didn't know what in the world I was doing. This is from the brand Alima Pure, and all of the makeup that I will be showing you I'm actually wearing right now. This is their satin matte foundation in the beige one. I'm hoping that these colors pick up when you're watching this. I have their bronzer as well in the Maracabio. I'm not quite sure if I'm pronouncing that correctly. This is what it looks like. It almost kind of looks like the foundation. And then finally, their satin matte blush. This is in the Apple Blossom. And this is what it looks like. To apply the makeup, I have some makeup brushes. I'm probably not using the correct brushes. Help me out in the comments, guys. So these are from the brand e.l.f. and I just got them from Target. And I just realized that I don't have the eyelashes up here that I like to wear. I must have forgotten those in the bathroom. So I'll take a picture of them and put them on here on the screen. But they are the Ardell Wispies that are my absolute favorite eyelashes. And then to apply the eyelashes, I have this Duo Lash Glue. It is in the dark tone. This isn't more natural or anything like that. If any of you guys have recommendations for natural lash glue, that would be great. Leave them down in the comments because it's a very sensitive area. So having a more natural alternative would be great. And then the 2 other things that I am packing are my eyeliner and my eyebrow pencil. These are also 2 things that I haven't fully converted to more natural. So if you guys have any recommendations on that, I would love that. I don't even know what brand these are because I've touched them so much that the brand name has kind of came off. And in this pouch here, I will be putting all of my makeup. If you've seen any of my previous videos, I do unboxings of this brand every single month. So Live Fit Apparel is my favorite athletic apparel company, and every single month I get a subscription box called the Live Fit capsule, and this is one of the items that came into one of the subscription boxes, and I was so excited for it. I thought that this was going to be perfect for traveling. And all of the items that I just showed you with the exception of probably my chapstick, would go into my suitcase. So I'm gonna grab all the items that I would put into my backpack, which isn't that many, but I will show you that, and then I'll show you the healthy snacks as well. All right, moving on to the items that I like to put into my backpack. So the backpack I got from another LitFit capsule that I had opened a couple months back, and I have a little avocado plush on it because I'm obsessed with avocado. Some of the things that I will be putting into my backpack include a notepad because I get so many ideas whenever it is that I am traveling. Pencil, pen, highlighters. I take the highlighters because I like to take a book with me as well, and I like to highlight things. And if I want to get some work done, I also take my laptop with me. Then there's like, you know, the boring things such as your wallet. You want to make sure you take your phone, your chargers. And one thing I highly recommend you invest in is an external battery, because when you're on vacation, you're more than likely out and about all day and you don't want your phone dying. So totally get an external battery for that reason. And two items that I have previously mentioned were the lip balm and then a hand sanitizer, because I will more than likely get hungry for snacks. And speaking of snacks, let's just hop into those right now. The first one is from the brand Larabar, or Larabar, I'm not quite sure how you pronounce it, but this is their banana bread. This is so good, you guys, and I love it because it's only made up of three ingredients, including almonds, dates, and unsweetened bananas. The other favorite that I have is the pineapple upside down cake. I also like to munch on things when I'm on the plane. So I have these Lesser Evil Paleo Puffs in the Himalayan pink salt flavor. They are made up of much better ingredients. They're also dairy, gluten, grain free. And I think these would also be a really good idea for the kids. I mean, if I was a kid, I would totally eat these. And for some protein, I have some Epic bars. So this is the chicken sriracha flavor. And then my other favorite is the venison and sea salt and pepper. By the way, if you're wondering where it is that I buy these healthy snacks from, I have done healthy grocery haul videos in the past year on my channel, and I will show you where it is that I buy all these healthy snacks. So I highly recommend you watch those videos. I've gone to Walmart, Target, Trader Joe's, Fresh Thyme, and Whole Foods. The other snack that I like to get is these pork rinds. They are the sea salt and pepper flavor. The last thing that I put into my backpack is a water bottle, because the last thing that you want to do is let dehydration ruin your vacation. So I always take a water bottle. Just make sure that when you are going through TSA lane, you have this empty, or else they're not gonna allow it, or they're gonna make you dump it somehow. My link to my Instagram will be in the description. And in the meantime, I will put some videos here that you might be interested in. Otherwise, take care. I hope this video was helpful, and I will see you next Thursday. Bye, guys.